folks. Welcome to another Triple T Thursday. For those just joining us, that's Tools, Tips, and Talk, where we'll talk about info for the knife maker. In today's episode, cutting steel and all the tools you can use to cut steel, why you want to use some, why you want to use others, and generally, what are the best ways to cut steel? Let's get going.
So let's talk about cutting steel. The first one that most people are probably familiar with and most people will start out with is an angle grinder with a cutoff disc. Most people are going to be familiar with this, but this is going to be kind of your lowest point of entry. It is also my least favorite, just because this is a really dangerous tool. It spins at 15,000 RPMs, and it's really messy and dirty. You get grinding, you get sparks everywhere, you get grind everywhere. It just makes a mess of the shop. So I really don't use this unless I have to. So let's go on to number two. So here's, I wouldn't say it's my second choice, maybe it's probably tied with the angle grinder, is a chop saw. And this chop saw has got a 14 inch, I forget, abrasive blade on it. And basically just cuts lines, and you can move this thing back and forth, lock your stock in it. I got this thinking I would use it to cut slices of Damascus for doing mosaics. I don't know if it's me. I'm pretty sure it's not me. Either this isn't a good chop saw, or I can't do anything that's of any significant width on this, because this blade just wanders and it will not cut really, really straight lines, and you get all kinds of slag on the end. It's just really messy, and it has the same issues as the angle grinder, meaning it's really messy, shoots sparks everywhere, kicks off smoke, not from the engine or anything, but from what it's cutting. So I rarely use this. I probably will use this less than I use the angle grinder. What I sometimes use this for is just cutting flat stock for Damascus. It was not a good purchase. If I had to do it again, I don't think I would purchase this one. What I wish I had or had purchased is to save up the money. I think these are like $180 or something like that. I wish I would have saved up and bought a metal cutting saw that actually has a blade that can cut metal with an actual blade with teeth. They're quite expensive. I think they're around $500, and the blades are over $100 a piece, but you get much more accurate cuts. So yeah, I might invest in one of those. The one downside on that is that the blade is still pretty thick, and you're losing material when you're doing a lot of cuts on a single piece of, say, Damascus. You will be losing a lot of material with the cut. So yeah, chop saw, not my favorite. Metal cutting saw would be my next bet. Let's go on to the next one. So here is a portaband, meaning a portable bandsaw. This one's from Wen. There's a link in the description for all of these tools. I think this one was around $300, something like that. Great, great tool. I have this swag off-road table that's an aftermarket table that just kind of screws into it. And then you can get ones with legs, but I have, I kind of like moving this, so I always have it just locked in a vise. Which is really cool, because then I can just take it off. I also plug it into a foot pedal down here so that I can just run it like that. So pretty cool. Saw does a great job. These blades, I think for $25 or $22, you get three blades. So I use this a lot for profiling, if I want to do just straight stock removal, or I'm cutting handle scales or whatever. All forms of cutting, I'll use this saw. This also has a speed control on the side. If you want to cut really slow, you want to cut really fast. So great saw. Would highly recommend the Wen Bandsaw. Again, look for a link down in the comments, sorry, in the description for this saw. The last one I'm going to go over today, another Wen saw, another Wen Bandsaw. This is a horizontal bandsaw. The reason I got this was what I mentioned before that I thought I was going to use the chop saw for, I use this for, which is slicing up Damascus for mosaics or just generally cutting any kind of stock. The great thing about this, you put your stock in, you turn this thing on, you sit it on it, and then you let go, and then this thing will hit a switch here and it'll turn off automatically when it's done. So that's great because you can be doing something else and have it cut. These saws go pretty slow on purpose because they're metal cutting saws, but you can run this in a horizontal mode like this, and there's a table that comes with it here, but it's so slow. I don't like doing any kind of profiling or cutting on this. I would definitely use the portaband for that. I just don't like the setup, and it's too low and it's hard on your back. And so I use this strictly for horizontal cuts. The blade on this, I think they're like, I'm guessing $15 a piece, I think, for the blades. They last a long time. I probably get, I don't know, 150 cuts out of them, something like that. So they're really good blades. Lasts a long time. If you decide to get this on this, you know, let's be honest, it's one of the lower end models for a horizontal bandsaw. Like this type of bandsaw can go up to $1,500, $2,000. This one was $350. So, but it's great for what it does. Be ready though, when you get this saw, or there's a bunch of different knockoffs that are just like it, you are gonna have to do a lot of trimming it in when you get it. It will not cut straight, and it's gonna frustrate you that it doesn't cut straight out of the box. What you need to do, basically get a bunch of stock you're gonna keep doing cuts on. Get yourself a square and keep testing, spin it around, make sure that it's cutting square on every angle, because you can adjust these. This bolt and this bolt will allow these pieces to spin independently, and that will angle your blade. So it took me a while to get this right, but once it's dialed in, it works well. If you find it's been cutting straight, and then all of a sudden it's not cutting straight at all, it's because you need a new blade. I found this out the hard way. And as soon as I put a new blade on, it was back to cutting straight and fine. So, great saw. Some other features of this saw. It has this little piece here. So if you want to do exactly the same cut, you just put this here, butt it up against, cut, butt the next piece up again, and then you don't have to keep measuring. You can just measure from the blade here. Other reason this is nice compared to, say, a chop saw is the width of the blade. You're not going to get any thinner than a bandsaw blade for cutting if you want to lose the least amount of material. A chop saw abrasive blade is probably four times as thick as this blade. So yeah, you're going to lose a lot. This thing also does different angles. When I'm doing mosaics, I'm usually setting this at 35 degrees, so I'm cutting at angles. I watch my explosion pattern video. I'll put a link at the top and you'll see when I use this. And you'll see me use this on all kinds of, you know, all my Damascus. I cut off the ends. I do everything on this saw. If you want it to cut slower, you can tighten this. I have this crank so it cuts as fast as it can. So, great saw for the money. I don't think you can beat it. I'm really happy with this saw. This also, you can adjust this back and forth if you want to cut narrower pieces. So, really good saw.
So there you have it, folks, cutting steel. Let's move on to today's viewer knife. This one's from Don Drurier, who's been a member of the channel since the beginning. So, and I see maybe some things that I've done in the past appear in this knife. So I'll put it up here and then I'll zoom in after. So this knife is a Turkish twist. It's got a gut hook. It's a really beautiful pattern. It's got a potok, brass, and walnut handle. So good job, Don. I really like this one. I'm a sucker for the Turkish twist pattern. And one I'm going to redo again at some point, but it looks really, really good. So thanks for joining me, folks. Hope you got something out of today's episode, and we'll see you on the next one.